get it down on the dead day. I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop it, the nigga, the server, determined, the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping a run, popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances. I'm gonna stay in Atlanta. Most of them move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand, the colors are mixing again. Grabbing a stick with my hand, I drop my guts. The world is us, so what? Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust, kicking the door when I come.
Today, from Highmark Stadium in Orchard Park, New York, it's week 13 of the NFL on EA Sports. The Buffalo Bills taking on the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Winter is just around the corner as you get a look at Bills Stadium just south of Buffalo, New York. The folks in Buffalo love their Bills, and a moment ago they entered to the delight of this sold-out crowd. They're set for football as their Bills will do battle with the Pittsburgh Steelers. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. And Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped it to 23-yard line. So here are the Steelers now to take over for the first time. And they will be led out by their 6'4 quarterback.
And I think it's safe to say that, and I heard him say it in the post-game press conference, that was a team win last week because he didn't really play up to his normal standards, throwing two interceptions.
No touchdown.
Yeah, didn't offset it at all, but the team found a way to get it done.
Third down, Rose. He finds his man, complete. That's ball. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, they'll use him a lot out of the backfield. He had five catches a week ago, and he makes another catch here for good yardage.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Again, he'll drop to throw. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. To throw again. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. This is taken at about the 14. 8 yards on the return following a punt of 41. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10. The Buffalo offense coming out, and it is Josh Allen who is at the helm.
He had the numbers of the game last week that if you win, you talk about him being a gritty guy, managing the game, getting it done. But they lost, so obviously two interceptions, one touchdown pass, that's not going to be good enough. Got to get that changed around.
And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down. A look there at his numbers on the ground a week ago. Pretty good as he found himself in the end zone on two separate occasions.
And those are the most important numbers because no matter what you pile up prior to the goal line, getting in is all that matters. Putting those numbers up on the board, and they love them when they're sixes.
Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. And on third and eight, defensively, they're going to beef up the secondary. Six defensive backs. Now Allen. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that third down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field. Defensively, make sure you know where he is because he understands how to get open in key situations.
They'll run on first down with Singletary, and he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. So the hand got inside the face mask that time. Looked like a pretty easy call.
And it was, and we saw this in their loss last week. Penalties at inopportune times that led to their demise.
So a big penalty there on the face mask leads to first and 10. Allen going to give this one to Singletary. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down. The last run got a couple here. Second and 8. To the air. Allen. Throw left side. Taken in by Jefferson. They follow up the gain of 2 with a gain of 1 that time. This defense for the Steelers, they were terrific last week in the win over Denver.
Well, let's face it, when you hold someone to just 6 points in a game, the feeling that you have among your team is that you're not going to lose very many of those. That's the way to get it done.
Throwing is Allen on third. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down. And Bohorquez on to punt as he gets it away. No returning this one. It sails out of bounds, and they'll spot it right at the 20. So Pittsburgh retakes the field for their second offensive possession. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
Not much there, only a yard. Second and 9 now from the 21. Back to throw. Rose. Now he's trying for Smith-Schuster, but it's intercepted. Tre'Davious White with a pick.
Well, if you go by the numbers, you'll find as the temperature goes down, so does the passing efficiency. And now that we're in December, even the routine throws are going to be harder for the quarterbacks. And this one, it winds up getting picked off.
So here come the Bills out for their second drive. And they are a game under 500 now following the loss a week ago. And this is a team, Charles, that just has not been able to string victories together.
Yeah, they're certainly going the wrong way, aren't they? Because it looked like they had things pointing in the right direction, but now they've lost 2 straight, and that means this game is vital, extremely important, because if they fall 2 games below 500, the road back into playoff contention, awfully difficult. And remember, this drive started off following the turnover, and they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
Here we go now on first and goal. They run here with Singletary. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
Tackling's obviously critical down near the goal line. That was great work there to make the hit behind the line and make sure he doesn't get any further. Did a really nice job wrapping up and not letting him loose.
They'll try again on second and goal after going backwards to the 12. Here's Allen to throw it. Dancing to his left. And inside the 5 here before he's out of bounds right at the 3. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and that's going to bring up an interesting third and goal.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive game. And he's got his tight end Knox for a Bills touchdown. Dawson Knox, his second touchdown on the season. And the Bills have taken the early lead.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury. And it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run. He finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
Extra point attempt to come here. And it's 7-0 Buffalo. A drive there of just 4 plays. And it ends in a Buffalo touchdown. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Fielded just outside the goal line. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Steelers offense now, they head back onto the field. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number 2?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
These are his numbers from last week's contest. A boatload of carries, 111 for yards and a touchdown.
And the way they ran the ball last week has to bring a smile to the faces of the entire coaching staff, because not only are they seeing a back pile up yardage, they're seeing an offensive line in sync, and that bodes well this late in the season.
Now here's a throw that's complete, and he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. Just the first quarter, but tackling going to be so important going forward. They've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you, from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season open opponent, and they had a receiver that could shake and bake with the best of them. I tackled him on the first pass of the game, and the relief was incredible. Ended up having a pretty decent ball game. But if I had missed him, it would have been a long night.
So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 43. They'll try the left side. It's ball. Oh, nice move. And good job of just fighting through one tackle there to pick up about 3. Second down coming up. To throw on second down. Rose looking left side, and he's got a man. That's ball. And he gets it down to the 32.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
He finds his man complete. It's Sharp. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. They'll wind up losing 3 here on the play. And that'll bring up a 3rd-and-11 situation.
Time to give a little credit here. That was an excellent read by the guys on the defensive side of the ball.
Oh, you're crediting your defense.
Gotta credit them on that one, because they tried to fool them, right? Tried to trick them. Ran a screen. and they went to it and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
On third down, Rose being chased out left, finding room to the 20. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the five. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll check on his status when we return to Orchard Park. A first opportunity for the Steelers in the red zone. They've got a first and goal to go at the seven. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And that'll get him halfway there as he takes it from the 6 to the 3-yard line. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. He'll try again. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it will go as a 1-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
Line of scrimmage at the 4. Here's third and goal. Looking to throw. Rose. Yeah, he's got it. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the 1. They're able to hold him to 3 there, and that leads to a 4th and goal. They'll try and run for it. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. A great effort there with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Steelers are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
This defense held out as long as they could, but ultimately the running game wears them down from the 1-yard line.
And that gets set up throughout the entire drive, doesn't it? And when you put those big bodies and determination into that carry, the end result, touchdown.
On here, Brandon McManus for the point after. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. That one in the books as a 12-play drive, and it ends with a 1-yard touchdown run. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Taken at the goal line. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Now the Bills offense gets ready to head back onto the field. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails because they had it going pretty good last time too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
From the 36, Allen working the middle here. That's complete to Knox, the tight end. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. On first down, Singletary. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
That was a terrific play, causing a loss. As a middle linebacker, simple. You can either fill holes or you can attack them, as he did there.
Second and 11. On the handoff, running left, Singletary. And he'll get this one across midfield and down into Steeler territory. So third and 5, defensively expecting pass. They've got 6 DBs out there. Now Allen. To the right side, a complete to Jefferson. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. So 5 yards here, 5 on the play. And that'll bring up fourth down. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38.
That's caught by Gabriel Davis. And he's taken down inside the 30. Seven, our score after one. Play action. Now it's Allen. Rush coming, and he's taken down. T.J. Watt has now recorded 10 sacks on the season.
Well, they sent him on the blitz from that linebacker spot, and boy, he got there quickly.
He certainly did, and obviously he could have used a block from his running back, but I think you nailed it right there. The defender got into the backfield so fast, it's hard for anyone to react.
So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Another try after the first down sack. Allen forced out to his left. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. The Bills on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This will be a tough third and 18. That's complete to his running back, Jefferson. They get only 4 that time, as that leads us to a fourth down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Tyler Bass out for the Bills' field goal. From the right hash, this from 48. The kick by Bass is good. And the Bills have taken the lead. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, Parker, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. So I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting 3? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find one to get you into the end zone and get you 6?
Comes the Steeler offense now, ready to see what they can do here. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
High throw, but he makes the catch. And he's brought down after a very nice gain.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
They'll run on first down. Ball. Tremaine Edmonds there to bring him down. The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Back to throw. Rhodes. He's got his tight end Freiermuth over the middle. Now we have Hyde still on the ground here. Staying down after that last play. We'll check on his status when we return to Orchard Park. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Operating from the gun, Rose. Here's Freiermuth again. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on 2nd down. To throw on 2nd down. Rose. And he's got a 1st down as the tackle made at the Bills' 20-yard line.
You always worry about those smaller receivers running through that gnarly patch of land in the middle of the field. But he did a really nice job there holding on to the football and protected himself as best he could while completing the play.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw.
Quick completion here to Johnson. 7 yards, the pickup there.
On a jet sweep, this is Johnson.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
Seventh play of the drive now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. Looking to throw. Rose.
Open man. That's the tight end, Freiermuth. And the Steelers are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And he's in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. A great play there with his 2nd touchdown here in this first half. And the Steelers are going to retake the lead.
So his strong first half continues as he finds the end zone here for the 2nd time.
And definitely good blocking at the point of attack. And you just have to love watching the way he can create space down near the goal line. And he's able to take it into the end zone.
Now McManus to tack on the extra point. And that makes it 14-10. So that drive, 80 yards, 9 plays. And it ends with a 1-yard touchdown run. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
Taken in at the 3. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line.
Now the Bills offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. To throw again on 2nd down. Allen finding Knox there, complete. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10.
That's tough to play zone defense when they can just curl up right there in front of you.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we talk about finding the soft spot defensively. How do you make sure they don't find the soft spot like they did there?
Tough to do, because what they normally will do is run routes that'll pull you out of that spot that they want to get into. That's what we call not taking the cheese, right? Don't go for the mousetrap. But it's hard to do, because when you see a guy cutting that in that direction, you tend to go towards him.
Allen gonna throw. Right side, Davis.
And he is gonna have a Bills 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
The counter, this is Singletary, and he'll just plow right into a host of tacklers. Nothing there at all, and it'll be 2nd and 10. To throw, it's Allen. A quick throw going to be caught by Diggs, and they're going to have themselves another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Steelers 26.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision, and receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
On 1st down, Singletary, and they've got it in the red zone now, down at about the 19.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. On the give, this is Singletary. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Here's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line. Working out of the shotgun. Here's Allen firing quickly here, and that's complete. And the Bills are going to have a 1st and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line. They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. It'll be a 3-yard pickup, and it brings up 2nd and goal.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed. On 2nd and goal, Allen. And they're going to get to him, a sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. Stephon Tuitt, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
Well, they had the right down and the definite distance to take a shot downfield, but it didn't work out the way that they had envisioned.
No, that's a situation where if you take a sack close to the line of scrimmage, it's not that bad, but a loss like that, you can't take a sack there.
Yeah, absolutely. The one thing you cannot do, they did.
Allen now on 3rd and goal, and that is incomplete. Well, so a drive that spans all that time, and yet you may only come away with 3 points here.
Well, your defense, all right, they actually like these long drives. They get to rest over on the sidelines for a while, but when you're not finishing with points in terms of touchdowns, that's frustrating. They've got to figure out how to close out these long drives and get 6s instead of 3s.
So they get the field goal, but that was a 14-play drive to get 3.
It sounds like you're going negative on me.
I was.
Sounds like you're thinking the 3 is just not that good.
And people say that we're negative sometimes. So.
Well, here's the deal. Getting the 3 is good. Obviously, you would think on a 14-play drive you're going to get 6 out of it. But that type of a drive can pay dividends later on because you might wear the defense down.
They'll run on 1st down. Ball. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
Well, they set the power set out there, and their job is to be man on man and move people so they can run the football. But that time, too many men didn't get moved in the box defensively. They end up throwing it for a loss.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's 2nd and 12. To throw. Rose. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. 3rd down. To throw on 3rd down. Rose. They'll find Juju Smith-Schuster. And he will have a Steelers 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
Well, that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
On 1st down. It's Ball, and they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2.
They just keep trying, but so far, finding no room for him to run.
None whatsoever. In fact, you run the numbers. He's under 3 yards a carry at the moment. On 2nd down, there's the option going left. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. They go play action here on 1st down. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. So now a fresh set of downs, first and 10 after roughing the passer. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Jenkins. Down he goes at the 10 with a solid pickup of 8. Second and 2, first down marker at the 8. From the gun, Rose. Eluding the pressure right. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Looking to throw. Rose. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
And I can see the officials kind of looking at each other down there, silently wondering, does this meet the level of grounding? Fortunately, he did have a receiver in the area, but I have seen less obvious throwaways called as penalties.
This is caught. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. This Buffalo defense has stood their ground. This is third and goal. Open man is Johnson. Touchdown, Steelers. Deontay Johnson, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Steelers are going to add on to their lead. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
McManus now for the extra point. And with that, the lead is up to 8. A 10-play drive that time. And it ends with a Pittsburgh touchdown. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be fielded inside the 5. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. Josh Allen leads the offense out for their next possession. Been a decent start for him here in this first half, but they're losing. And I think as the captain of the offense, you probably always feel like you need to do more in that situation.
The best have always felt that way, and they won't settle for anything less. So right now, his goal is to increase what he's doing on the field, try to make sure his teammates come along with him, and he feels like if I do better, everyone will do better. And that's what we're seeing from him right now. Got to have a little extra determination.
Yeah, a little extra determination. He has thrown the touchdown pass, no interceptions for him personally to this point. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. From the gun, it's Allen. Escaping the pressure right. First down and more for Allen. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Allen now looks to throw. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
To throw again on second down. Allen out to the left. He's got his tight end, Knox. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So third down now. They need the 27-yard line for a first. Allen. And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going to go down. Alex Highsmith. In there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year.
That's 3 sacks now, and that's not much of a surprise to me, nor should it be to you. This team, They lead the league in sacks.
Yeah, they do. This is something that we are starting to witness time and time again. So look at this. Here's the field goal unit coming out. And he is going to need to bomb this one. This will approach NFL record territory. It's a 62-yard attempt. That's leaking to the right, and he missed it by a foot or two. It's no good. So we've reached halftime here with the visiting Steelers out in front. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thank you very much. We're starting to get near the home stretch of this NFL season. It's week 13. So let's get an update on what's going on. We'll begin our tour up at First Energy Stadium in Cleveland, where it was the visiting Chargers who were able to come in and steal one on the road. Justin Herbert sharp in the victory as his guys double up their record to 8-4 on the year. From there, we're off to check out another game, and they've got the lead over the visiting Arizona Cardinals. Robert Woods, a touchdown reception. Lastly, let's check in on our nation's capital to see what's happening with the Washington football team at home at FedEx Field. And they lead that one over the visiting Green Bay Packers. Antonio Gibson, a touchdown run in that first half. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast teams of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. And the half will begin with a touchback. The quarterback, Josh Allen, the focus of our player spotlight. And maybe he's starting to wave the white flag a little bit. He's playing pretty well, but the pressure, it's got to him.
Has to find a way to step around it, step through it, or just handle it. Because as you mentioned, he's having a pretty good day overall. Just the hits keep coming and taking those sacks. That's not the way that they want to finish a ball game with their quarterback on the ground so much.
He'd like to stay upright. When he's been upright, he's been pretty good. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at him and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all, challenging that defense. And on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Right back to him on first down. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down.
I know we can't hear what's going on in that huddle right now, but I'll guarantee you at least one offensive lineman is saying, my bad, we simply couldn't move them off the line of scrimmage. We've got to do a better job trying to root those guys out of there.
From the 40 now on second down, Allen buying time to his left. And Allen will have the first down as he's able to slide to avoid the contact at the end.
When we're talking about a quarterback duel where they're matching each other pass for pass, how about the footwork in this with both of these guys running the ball well?
Yeah, they've mixed in the run game. You're exactly right. Now, both coaches might not like how much their quarterbacks have taken off, but another example right there of just good mobility. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
It's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
After the loss, they'll come up second and 13. Now a handoff as they run left side. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup. Throwing now is Allen. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
That was just a good example of taking what the defense gave him. No one opened downfield, knew where his safety valve was, swung it out to him. He gets upfield and picks up the first down. Well done all the way around.
Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 36. They'll run on first down. Callahan. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Now a stoppage here as we've got a Bill shaken up on the play. We'll check on his status when we return to Orchard Park. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Here's Allen. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. And to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23.
Third and one, partner. No need to be fancy there. Just use some force and move forward and pick up the first down.
Game working, they'll stick with it on first down, and he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. We'll check on his status when we return to Orchard Park. Second down at 4. To throw. Allen. It's Knox, the tight end, making the catch. Call it a gain of 3 on the play. And that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10.
Man, what were they thinking on defense there? That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you ought to have a few men in the box there.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. Now here's a handoff out of a gun. And a nice pickup there as he'll take it from the 10 down to the 5-yard line. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4-yard pickup leaves him with third and one. On third down, Callahan. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on third.
That was a huge play on third down. So now what? Do you go for it? Do you trust your offense? Or do you want to put on your defense to try and get the ball back? Me? I'm going for it right here.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on fourth and one. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he'll wind up being knocked back to the 3-yard line. They stop him up short on fourth and goal from the one. And the Steeler D will celebrate the goal line stand. On first and 10, Rose. Flush to his right. And he is caught by Smith-Schuster. And he is out of bounds, able to get it across the 20-yard line.
And they were backed up to start the drive, but not anymore. Now, that's the play call that the offensive coordinator had in his head. You saw the end result. He wanted to go ahead and push the ball downfield, and that's what they did. And they wound up with good yardage there to get things rolling.
Now they can breathe a little easier, some room to operate as they've got it first and 10 now out past the 20. Operating from the gun, Rose. Rolling to his left. They'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
And the Bills are going to get him as he goes down. A.J. Epinesa. Credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of six.
So they were trying to set up a screen there, but that one just too slow in developing.
Yeah, too slow in developing and well read, because that ends up being a bad feeling for the quarterback. When he's got no blocking in front of him, his guys are just going to let defenders go, and they're coming for him. So if it's not there, you just got to throw the ball on the turf at your running back speed.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Open man completes it to Smith-Schuster. Just a five-yard pickup, but it leads to fourth down.
Timing is so important on a route like this, because he's going to line up out right and then cut straight across the field. I think the ball might have come out a count or two too late, because by the time he was able to secure it, not much of a chance to turn it upfield.
The Steelers send out their punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. 44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. Taken from just outside the 30. A nice job getting free on the return for 13 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. And last time, they had it fourth and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive.
Hey, a simple tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow them to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Make it now 3 tackles for a loss in this game, 1 for each quarter.
And for a guy who played defense in college, I can just tell you that he's feeling very satisfied right now by what he's doing. But he's elated because he knows what he's doing is helping his team win the game right now. Making some big-time plays, getting into the offense's backfield, and spilling everything.
Flushed out right. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down. So the shotgun snap to Allen. And eventually taken down here. Great coverage downfield. And that'll bring up fourth down on a big sack with a loss of 5.
You know, on these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
Tyler Bass out for the Bills' field goal. This from 54 yards away. And that is no good. And this score will stay right where it is. Go. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead. Take him down. The Bills get to him. Now a stoppage here as we've got a Bill shaken up on the play. We'll check on his status when we return to Orchard Park. The Steelers send out their punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. A 47-yard punt, maybe a couple on the return. And the Bills will be backed up to start the drive. They'll have it first and 10. Buffalo set to get the football back here. And last time out, another missed field goal. So maybe their confidence wavering a little bit right now in the kicking game.
And I'm with you on that. I think at this stage, they'd love to not run him back out there in a tough situation. But let's face it, they may have to. So right now, the head coach is talking to the offense coordinator and saying, call this game like we're going to put it in the end zone. Let's try and take the field goal out of it.
On second and inches, Allen.
Slant route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
From the gun on third down, Allen. Wide open receiver complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them. And they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
Allen to throw once more. And this one is going to be off the mark, too far out in front. We're in the third quarter in upstate New York with a second and 10. Hands it off out of the gun. He'll get three up to midfield. From midfield, here's Allen. Fourth down now after a loss of two. The Bills send the punter out as he'll kick it away for the second time. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. That one sails out of bounds. The side judge will walk it off. And he says it went out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Nice punt. So they'll play the field position game here as a very nice punt is going to pin them back.
Yeah, it's almost like watching a game of tennis, or do you prefer ping pong? You know, back and forth like that? That definitely was excellent, wasn't it?
On first down. It's Ball, and he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Looking to throw on second down. Rhodes. And able to get this one out just shy of the 25 at the 24. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure.